गुड आफ्टरनून टीचर्स, माय नेम इज जगन एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ श्री अरविंद सोसाइटी। सो दिस इज द सीरीज वेयर आई शेयर विद यू सम ऑफ द इनोवेटिव आइडियाज गिवन बाय द टीचर्स ऑफ डिफरेंट स्टेट। सो यस्टरडे वी स्टार्टेड अ न्यू बुक ऑफ अ न्यू स्टेट विद यू, द बुक ऑफ दिल्ली, द इशू वन वी स्टार्टेड विद यू, एंड बिफोर दैट वी वर शेयरिंग विद यू आइडियाज ऑफ अंडमान एंड निकोबार टीचर्स। So there are teachers, they have always some question for us. They tell us in the comment box also that, sir, how we can send our innovative idea to you so that we can also be rewarded. So today I want to share with your website. There you can share your innovative idea with us, and then you can share, if you have more than even one innovative idea, you can share with us. And as our program is Zero Investment Innovation for Education Initiatives, so your idea must be zero based innovative idea. So I would like to tell you some parameters first, then we will start our session. So there are some parameters to send your innovative idea. The first is your idea should be zero based. So your idea should not have there should not be so much of investment of money or anything, as this is the program ZIII, Zero Investment Innovation for Education Initiative. So here we are using minimal investment or the resources which are available in the school. We are going to use only those resources, and based on that we are going to implement any idea in the school. And your idea must be implemented already, as you are the teachers and you always keep doing something new in the school. So the idea which you are doing already in the school, that idea is mandatory. That is the second parameter. So your idea should be implemented. Because there are some teachers, they have some such good suggestions which they have in their mind, so they share with us, but those ideas are not, we want ideas where teachers have seen some good results and they have found some good benefits of those innovative ideas. And the third is your idea should be documented. So sometimes what happens, even we have some ideas that we can speak, that we can tell to anybody, we can share it, we can show it, but we don't know how to write it. So here teachers should be able to write their innovative ideas, so we can share with other teachers in a written form. So because your idea goes to the country, the different part of the countries, so different part of the country, so your idea should be on the written based. And there are some several another parameters also, like your idea, there should be any benefit related to the school, like it should increase the number of girls in the school, it should increase the level of education, it should increase the safety of the girls. Any idea which is helping any student, teacher, school, community, that idea is suitable for our program. So now let's go ahead and let's talk about today's case study, that is learning through games. And we all know you teachers also do some of the great things in the school, that you teach your students by games only. So there are some teachers in Delhi also, they have also done something in the school. By teaching, while playing game, they have taught their students some good things in the school. So those ideas I'm going to share with you. So before that, let's understand this, what is learning through games first. So as we know, there are many students, I will say, that they do not want to read the book. They do not want to come to school and start studying. They don't like to study like that. If we give them a book and ask them to read it for 1 hour, so believe me, they will think like this is kind of burden for them, and they will not be so much ready to read the book. So in this condition, what happens? At the same time, if we tell any student that today we are going to play a game, or it can be cricket, football, any other game, so students are so excited to play the game. Even if it is outside so much of sunlight, if outside there is so much of hot, even then they will be able to play, they will enjoy it even. So how it happens when they are in the class, at that time they are not studying, they are feeling bored, they are feeling lazy, even lethargy, so much of lethargy. But when they go outside and playing game in the class, and at that time they are feeling good, they are not feeling low, they are feeling energetic. So because games have this, students enjoy game, teachers enjoy game, I believe everybody enjoys game. So we can say, we can give this final statement to this, that almost every student likes to play games more than a reading book, or more than study in the class. So what if sometime we give our students a surprise game to in our class, the students, we are going to play a game today, and in that game you are going to enjoy a lot, and this game is going to be like you have already played this game, but today you are going to play this game with your class fellows and the teachers also sometime. So here students become so much of excited, like that what game we are going to play and how we are going to enjoy this game. The students are so excited about it. So today we will talk about this, and the first innovative idea is the game of Pittu. So in Hindi we say that Pittu ka khel, and in English we say game of Pittu. You must have also played in the childhood that when we used to play this game, there was a blocks of bricks earlier when we used to play, and that time we had one ball and we used to throw that, and the block used to just fall down on the floor, and then we used to come and collect it quickly and make the tower again. The team used to tower or where the team was not, the ball was not touched to the person, or that ball was not hit to the person who is collecting, who is making the tower big, at that time the team was the winner. So like this, the game is similar in the class, but there is the teacher has added learning in this game. How teacher has added the learning in the game? Let's understand this. So teacher saw that there are students in my class, they like to play games, but while they like to play games, so what game I can bring to the school, or what game I can bring to the class that my students will enjoy the game or enjoy my class and they will keep learning. And so teacher saw the first problem, that what is the problem which students face in the class. So there are students, the students are not able to learn spellings of the word. If I ask my student that according to the level of the class I'm talking about right now, so if I ask any first or second class or third class student, so that what is the spelling of mango, that student will come, he will get confused a little bit because he doesn't know about this. But if you make him excited, because excitement level can take you through anywhere, you are ready to learn everything, you are ready to play, you are ready to risk or danger your life sometime for excitement, as we see in a daily life. So here teacher did the same thing. Teacher started playing game with students, and so teacher, when students became so excited at that time, so students had the courage to learn all the words, the spellings and everything, because they had very less time, very short time they had to take decision in the class when teacher played this game. So now let's understand the implementation, how you all teachers can implement this idea in this school and get the benefit of this innovative idea. So what happens in this? So a teacher asks all the students to bring some blocks of like wooden, it can be wooden or the bricks. So like we saw this much of shape like this. So around 8, 9, 10, it can be the number of any number of bricks can be bring, or the blocks we can bring in the class. And after that, teacher arranges one ball as well. And the ball should be like this, that should not hurt students. If you bring any ball which is very heavy and that can hurt students, that is going to be painful for the students. So we'll bring a ball which will not hurt any student, which will touch and thus it will go. So we'll arrange a ball like that. And after that, what teacher does, teacher arrange all the students, tell them again that students, there are on the every block or on the every brick, the one letter is written of English alphabet. So like if I talk about the same example, mango. So in mango, how many letters are there? M-A-N-G-O. So there are 5 letters in mango. So there will be 5 bricks or 6 bricks. In that condition, what will happen? Related to that word, that like mango, in 5 letters are there. Another, like if we talk about mango, if we leave mango, what other word we can make from that the same, those 5 letters? So this also becomes the task for the student at that time. So then there are 2 teams in the class. Teacher divided every student into the class into 2 groups. And after that, the one group throws a ball on that bricks, on the tower of that wooden blocks. And after that, once that is apart, that is basically on the floor, all the blocks are on the different place. So the ball is here and there. After that, the other team has to collect the ball quickly. At that time, they are also so excited when they have to collect the ball. And other team, where they have to make a word so quickly. If we say that, if they make a word man, because if we say M-A-N-G-O, mango, so at that time, M-A-N, man, they can make the word also man. So if they create a word man, so they will get 3 points in that. They will just quickly make a word and say, that ma'am or sir, we have made a word men. So at that time they will get 3 points. And how, where will we write those 3 points? So it is a choice of teacher. If teacher want to write those that numbers on the notebook, the teacher can write on the notebook also. But the better will be if teacher writes on the board, because when we write on the board, the students also feel that we have to get more marks like that. And after that, we write every single word also which students have made on that blocks. So later on, we can talk about those words. If there is any student who do not know the meaning of that word, so we can share the meaning of that word with that student also. So like this, we play this game in the class. And after that, as long as every team gets around 4 to 5 rounds, in those 4 to 5 rounds, which team makes more score, which team brings more numbers in while playing this game, or which team makes more words while playing this game, that team is the winner, because they have found so many words. They have arranged those blocks to make a new word in the class. So all these students are going to learn or they know the new word in the class. So I believe that you have loved this innovative idea. So you must have also played this innovative this game when you were a child. So we never thought that this game can be used in this way also. But the teacher, the name of the teacher is Sarita Sehgal. Sarita Sehgal ma'am is there, and the teacher is from APJ School, Sainik Vihar, Pitampura, Delhi. So she is the teacher. Thank you ma'am for giving this innovative idea. Now let's go ahead and let's talk about our another innovative idea. The name is ball games and the subject combination. So when we say if I talk in Hindi, so the word name is gend ka khel and vishay ka mel. So ball games and the subject combination. So here when we are talking about ball, so the another game is also connected to the ball. Here we are going to use ball that again, but for a different purpose, for playing in a different manner, we are going to play this game. How we do that? Let's understand this. So what happens in this game? So the name of the teacher is Hitendra Kumar Virani. The teacher is from Rajkiya Pratibha Vikas Vidyalaya, Shalimar Bagh, Nayi Delhi. So he is the teacher who has given this innovative idea. So how teacher this? Even teacher saw in the class that there are students. Those words are the students, they do not know sometimes the opposite word in the class, that what can be the opposite word of any word or any antonym, synonyms. So the students are confused so many times about it. So student teacher thought, what a game I can invent in my class, that's how all the students will learn all these words. So I'll play this game with you also, teachers, today. And you will tell me, if you're watching me on the Facebook page, you will tell me in the comment box that what word you get in your mind. And if you're watching me on the Zoom right now, you are going to tell me in the chat box. So let's go ahead and let's talk about it. So the ball games is what happens in this game. So teacher divides the class into two groups. After dividing the class into two groups, teacher takes a small test of all the students, a quick test. In quick test, what happens? The teacher asks all the students to any question so quickly. Like you student, you have to answer this question in 1 second or less than 1 second or 2 seconds maximum, not less than this. So like this, what will happen? So teacher will come to know that my students, how quickly they are able to take action while they are performing or while they are living their life, like journally or in a real life, if I talk about. Because what happens sometimes, when we go outside, we are riding our bike, we are driving our car, we are going anywhere. So sometimes there are some situations, scenarios are there. At that time, we have to take decisions so quickly. Because if we do not take, if we take so much time to take a decision at that time, that becomes so late, that the time is so late. So at that time, there is no benefit. So so teacher thought, why, what I can do in my class, so my all these students are going to learn about it. So they will be able to take decisions so quickly, just in seconds they will be able to take decisions so quickly, and their decisions will be accurate because they have done a lot of practice to take decisions so quickly, and with the, so in just a milliseconds they can take decisions. So this innovative idea is going to help you a lot. So now let's understand this. Let's talk about the implementation of the idea. So first teacher comes, teacher tells about the idea. And after telling the idea, teacher shares with everyone that class, you all divide your class into two groups. So teacher gives this decision to all the students, because students have to do all the activity by their own, because they have to become self-dependent, the quick action taker, everything. So all the students start dividing the class. They choose their favorite person in the group, so they all can be participated together. So once all the groups are divided in the class and everybody is sorted, then teacher shares more rules of the class, the students. So for an example, this is a ball. So students, so this is the ball where we are going to play with this ball. And you all have to tell the opposite word when you get the ball. So for an example, you can say that this is the pen. So for an example, if ball is not there, if you're using pen, so because innovative idea means if you want to make any changes from your side, you can make any changes from your side only. And because ideas are to make your life comfortable, making the teacher's life comfortable, student's life comfortable. So that becomes completely teacher's choice. So for example, this is a ball. And after that, what will happen? So here is a Sonu and here is a Rahul. So what Sonu will do? Sonu will throw this pen to Rahul. And in this period of time when he's throwing the pen, at that time only the Rahul has to take decision, tell the right word, opposite word of any sentence. If Sonu is throwing the pen and saying girl, so the Rahul has to say boy, because boy is the opposite word of that. So now Rahul will throw the pen and say loser, so he will say winner. So like this, so quickly all the students have to take decisions in that, and students should know the opposite word of also. So what will happen, then teacher will write the point also in the class on the board. So any student who will not be able to answer the class, so that player will be out from the team, and the another player will get the chance to join the team, and that we will continue this game. At the end, the last player who is left for the team, we will count the numbers of both the teams, and then we'll see which team is the winner. There can be some several words also like this, like debit, credit, or profit, loss. These are some opposite words like journal, leader, goodwill, paid, prepaid, outstanding. Some words can be like this, or some words can be given like that. So like this, so teacher keep playing this game until the students are able to answer the questions. Students are able to find the words that they can answer. So here I want to share one more thing, that if you have your innovative idea, if you are implementing any idea in your school, that which you want to share with me today, or share with me the people, because the people who are watching on Facebook or the people who are watching on Zoom as well. So you can share your innovative idea with me. Once I give you the chance, that you can ask me any question which you have. If you have any question at that time, you have just feel free to ask me any question. I would love to answer all the queries. So like this, so teacher implement this idea in the class, and after that, what teacher get the benefit? The first benefit is the students know the playing game in a teamwork. So now the first step was there, where students divided the team into groups. Their teacher did not play any role there, just teacher gave the instruction. After that, the students' combination was there, that they had to divide the class into groups as soon as possible, because we are going to play a game, and when we are playing a game, at that time we have excitement to just do everything so quickly. And so the next thing is, the students have so excitement to learn new words. The learning becomes so engaging. So students try to learn more and more words from their home, so because the tomorrow, so their team do not lose the game. They are able to win this game so quickly. So they also try their best in the class. And the next, the best benefit of the teacher is that the teacher is getting benefit that the students are learning. The student who before he was not interested to learn in the class, at that time he was not feeling to learn, he was feeling bored sometime. So now when we are playing game, we are doing the same activity, we are teaching him, but by learning through games, and now he is learning more and more. So these were the two innovative ideas, teachers, and I believe that you are going to implement these ideas, at least one innovative idea in the class, once schools are open. So right now, this is your chance to ask me any question. So please feel free to ask me any question. What you have to do is just unmute your mic from the Zoom app. Then you can ask me any question. And if you are watching us on Facebook, you can tell me there about your innovative idea. You can ask me your question. Anything which you want to share with me, please feel free to ask me. I would love to hear all the queries and questions. So there are some people who are saying on Facebook, good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, everyone. So do we have some teachers? If you want to share in Hindi or any other language which where you prefer to speak, you can share in that language only. So I believe there is no confusion right now. So again, the teachers who have joined us later, so I want to share with them also how they can share their innovative idea or how you can share your innovative idea with us. Our website, www.ziei.com. So this is our website. There you can just when you put this website in your browser, this you will get one pop-up to submit your idea. You can submit your idea, innovative idea there. As soon as possible, we get your idea. Our team, our idea review team calls you and gets the information and we try our best that we try to explore your idea more and more by asking you some more questions. So your idea can be selected. So teachers, this is enough for the day. And let's meet tomorrow with another case study, self-learning. So I believe that you are going to implement these ideas. And till then, have a great day. Bye-bye.